Middle schoolers in Seattle's Northshore School District are being forced to take part in race-driven exercises where they must evaluate how privileged or oppressed they are. The exercise was inspired by this BuzzFeed-produced video.
I think it'd be silly for me to say I don't have a fair amount of privilege, considering like the country I live in and the job I get to do and the college I was allowed to go to.
I suppose being a white male will help me end up somewhere towards the front, but I'll take a few steps back from being gay.
I don't think I'll make it to the front. I think I'll maybe be in the middle.
Wow. Those adult subjects were prompted to take steps either backward or forward based on how they self-identify. Those who are more privileged finish the game ahead of their, quote, oppressed partners. Parents were rightfully outraged, but the school dismissed their concerns for some reason. Joining me now is the journalist and radio host who uncovered the story, Jason Rantz. You know him well. Jason, we see this everywhere. It is like, I see it almost as a cultic conditioning. Tell me what you're experiencing there in Seattle.
I think cultish is a really good way to talk about this. That's what it is. This is indoctrinating kids, and it's doing it without any parental consent or knowledge. The parent who just happened to be near her kid as she was learning remotely, and this kid was supposed to actually be in class, but they had taken a trip that was unexpected. So she grabbed her phone, and she was able to record a lot of this. And part of the messaging here in that video was that they were told that no matter how hard they worked, you're not going to be able to overcome being marginalized because you might be black or gay, which is the worst possible message to tell these kids. And then, of course, the teacher afterwards had the students self-identify. They looked at their own identities to see whether or not they had power or if they were marginalized, because then they could, and this is a direct quote from the teacher, figure out ways to dismantle systems of oppression. So they are creating these activists, they're starting very young with the intent of putting them out into the real world once they grow up to become CEOs and lawyers and doctors and politicians and start that revolution that right now they're not able to really fully get underway.
Well, you know, at the same time, they're going to create a generation of kids or kids who buy into this who will be depressed, who will have no confidence. And I would argue that maybe they're not going to become CEOs at all, that they're going to be marching, you know, and rioting, and they're going to be, you know, these kind of, it's going to be a very different environment, because I don't know how they're going to get a job or feel as though that they can compete in the real world if this is what we're teaching them.
Well, we're teaching them to always have a chip on one shoulder and always assume that the reason why you didn't get a job or you didn't get a promotion or you didn't get your way was because you're marginalized, when sometimes it's because you're just not the right fit or you didn't work hard enough. I hate the idea that we're telling kids you can't work hard. Sorry, I come from a marginalized class of people, and I'm doing fairly well because I'm trying to work really, really hard to get somewhere. We should be telling kids, work hard, stop with the identity.
It's the American story. And yes, it's not the same for everyone, but we do. And this is always what it means to be an American. And this is quite dangerous. So great job covering this and bringing this to our attention. Congratulations, Jason Rantz. Now, up next, a newly